Information so that we can start.
Yeah, hi guys. Welcome to .NETrix ReExist training program day 2. Today we have again Miss Vabna Gunwani. So she will teach you today routing ReExist and how we can consume the REST API with the help of ReExist. So let's welcome to Vabna Gunwani again for the second day of ReExist training. Yeah, Vabna.
Hello, Shailendra. Hello, everyone. Very good morning to all of you. So guys, let's take a quick start for the day. Can I get a more confirmations if I'm loud and clear to all of you quickly? We'll wait for one more minute and we'll start. Very good morning, everyone. Perfect, perfect. So guys, today I have two concepts in my plan. One is routing with React router. And second, after configuring the routes, in one of the routes, I will tell you how to communicate with REST APIs, how to consume third-party REST APIs in React application. Okay, it is a most important aspect of client-side framework to communicating with REST APIs and populating the data at the client side. Okay, so for that, we will not be working in the previous project. Quickly, we'll create a new project, and meantime, we'll be discussing the concept. We will get our project ready. So let's get started. We'll go to the Explorer, wherever you wanted to generate your project. Yesterday I had created React projects folder, and here I wanted to generate my new project. I told you guys, if you wanted to open the command prompt for this location, you just need to go to this address bar, write cmd, and the location gets open. Am I right? I will do that, Santa. Thanks for reminding me. I'm gonna create React app new project. I'm naming this as React Routing Project. Guys, I suggest you to please do it with me if you wanted to make practices along with me. So this is the React routing project I'm going to create, and I'll do all these two implementations, REST APIs and routing in this project. Once you get this project generated, please let me know. It will take a couple of minutes. Meantime, let's talk about exactly how the React routing is performed exactly at a client side.
Guys, please hold on. There is a disconnection at the Vabna end. So I think we lost the connection with her. Please hold on. We are reconnecting. Guys, please hold on. We are connecting with the Vabna again. Meanwhile, if you have any query, any doubt, please do ask. I'm here to help you. Vishveshwar, right? The new batch for ReactJS, we are going to start soon. The schedule you can check out at the dotnetx.com if you're interested to learn the ReactJS. So finally, Vabna came back. If you want to see the batch detail list, this is the link from where you can find out the batch detail list. This is especially for the Vishvesha, because Vishvesha asked for the training batch. So Vabna ma'am, can you share your screen, please? Vabna, can you unmute yourself, please?
Am I audible now?
Yeah, thank you. Now you are audible to us. Thank you.
Guys, I'm extremely sorry. Some disconnection was there. So here I'm going to create a new routing project. Once you are done with this routing project, please let me know over chat window. Then we can just take it up quickly. Meantime, I'm going to explain you exactly what is routing and how it performs at the client side quickly. So basically, guys, the moment we talk about routing basically implements to create a single page application at client side, either in Angular or React. The difference is that, as I discussed in my first session, React is a library and Angular is a framework. So if you wanted to integrate routing or single page application in React, you need third-party packages to install for React routing, and then you can implement these features in this particular application. But the moment we generate our Angular project, we have an entire MVC integrated with that. We have all the core packages available for all these functionalities. That's the difference. Single page application is a very fantastic play around for a client side. I will show you. Whenever you wanted to implement the single page application, you will not be navigating from one page to another page, just like a multi page. and you will be calling your component as per the route configuration over the root component only. I'm gonna tell you practically each and everything. And two, whenever the browser changes the URL to navigate to a particular route, and the interesting thing is your page will not be reloaded. So application should reconstruct the same view again and again rather than navigating from one view component to the another view component. Okay. There are three packages integrated for React routing. One is React Router and one is React Router DOM. And the third is React Router Native. Basically, the core packages is React Router, which comprises the core components which we require for developing any web application with routing. And when we talk about React Router DOM, it consists of all the routing APIs which are required for any particular browsers to render the client-side implementations. So guys, native is for mobile applications. I'm going to use second one because when we use React Router DOM, we get the integrated React Router concepts within it. So it's a complete package for web applications. So I'm going to take up the second dependency to configure the routes. Guys, can I get a quick confirmation if you get your project integrated? Vishwesh, not heavily, but yes, if mobile application needs to be constructed using React application, then React Native is the only option we have, okay? So guys, what is the command that we need to use to open this project in Visual Studio Code directly from command prompt? Yes, Kiran, you are absolutely right. Vinash, code dot. So once you are done with creating this project, open this in Visual Studio Code and start your project using npm start. Okay. Let me know by writing over the chat window project started or executed. We have one more way to open the project. Meantime, it is getting generated. I can directly open the Visual Studio Code. I can go to File, open the folder, not a workspace, guys. I'm suggesting you to open the folder. I had created my project folder in F drive. React projects, React routing project. Don't go inside it. Just keep it one step back and select the main folder and then select the folder. So you can see that project is still generating. So I have only two files generated here. Meanwhile, the rest is getting generated. We just opened with Visual Studio. Don't hesitate to write down over the chat window project started or executed. So guys, as we know that we need to integrate React routing, and for that we need a third-party package. And as I discussed over my presentation, that we will be using React Router DOM. That's a third-party package required for React web application. So I'm going to use a command npm install React Router DOM. So guys, one thing I wanted to tell you, when you actually have your project here and you wanted to run your project in one command shell, meanwhile your project is running, although I'm not running it because my project is getting generated. If you run your project from here, you don't have to stop your project and start again after installing the packages. Can you see this plus option, guys? Over the terminal, we have a plus option to keep adding more terminals. So you can just add an additional terminal and you can keep writing your npm install commands here. I hope I'm pretty clear about it. So by this drop down, you can anytime move on to our shell, or you can move on to your next command, next terminal that you have created. Is that clear to everyone? Is my screen visible to everyone? No, Gopinath, these are the open source packages integrated with npm. You can just directly install them. Guys, please give me a quick confirmation how many of you are active and for how many of you project is generated. And after that, install this React Router DOM package with the help of npm command. And I think my project is almost generated. I can go to my first PowerShell and I can start my project. Today I'm getting some errors to install the packages. So guys, I will not take much of your time in case I'm getting some bugs or some privilege issues which I should not get. So I can open this project, no problem. I'll not take much of your time. Guys, you don't do this, please. You already running your project, so just keep that ready with you. Okay guys, once you are done with this npm install React Router DOM, let's start configuring DOM. Let's start configuring the React Router. Guys, I will suggest you that in this project, I have many things which I really don't want. You can do the same in your new project. Under the SRC, let me delete the app folder, app files, which we had as a root folder. I wanted to delete index.cs. I wanted to keep my project so clean. Wanted to delete my logo and main.js. Wanted to delete the user and user.js. Because I had this project from yesterday, you can do the same in your current project. You can keep your index.js only and the report and test files, although you can delete them also because we don't want to test my applications, but I'm keeping it same. I have deleted some reference files from here. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to delete these three imports from here because I have deleted my logo. I deleted my app.js and the CSS file. Now what I will doing here under the SRC folder, I'm going to create a main.js. I will be using my main component as a root component. As you know how to create a new component, I'm going to import a React application component class. Extends the component class. import default main. Keeping the render method ready and returning the JSX main component. I have exported it from here. Going to my index.js, importing from main.js the main component and setting my main component as a root component. How many of you are clear with it? How many of you are clear with it, what I did? I just kept my SRC folder very clean, keeping my required files, deleted my app component also, kept my main.js as a base component, and I have set that as a root component. The moment I run my application, the root component should be the main component. Please give me a quick confirmation once you are done till this point, and we are good to start. I'm waiting here for 2 minutes. Once you are done with this, please let me know. Can I get more confirmations, please? Today also you want me to share the notepad PW in very emergency to share the code. I can do that. I just kept my code here and sharing it with you. The link that I have is guys, can you see my messages over the chat window? The URL is, guys, this is a URL. Can you please note down meanwhile people are writing the code? This is notepad.pw2m2fe22b. And if anyone can access, please share it over chat window so that everyone can take benefits. Abhijit, can you see my screen, dear? I'm already displaying it. It's highlighted over my screen after the main component. If anyone can access, please ping this URL over the chat window. Okay, guys, let's take it up forward because we have a proper plan. So it's a good time to start now. Again, I'm repeating with you guys, this is my main component and this is my index.js where my, you know, the stuffs are there. I wanted to create a component folder under the SRC components. Under this components folder, I am keeping a home.javascript. I wanted to create about.js. I wanted to create three components, home, about, and contact. And I wanted to render them in my routing file. I'm going to create a function component so that it will be lightweighted and this will contain the static implementations. So first of all, I will import my React library. Const home equals to, if any props are there, I'll be passing here. I'll help you to pass the props here as well, which were not to be discussed yesterday. And this is my div home page. Wanted to export default home. Similarly, I wanted to create a about.javascript. The about component, about page message, and exporting the about component. Similarly, way I'm going to create my contact component. Screen is not frozen, guys. Can you see my screen now? I have reshared. Can I get a quick confirmation, guys? Can I see my screen? Can you guys see my screen? Guys, just hold on for 2 minutes. Let me connect with Shailendra in case he needs to broadcast again. Guys, can you see my screen? Okay. I think Shailendra has to make me presenter once again. Something disconnected. Just wait for 2 minutes. Shailendra, are you there? Guys, please stay connected. I'm not able to connect with Shailendra, just 2 minutes. We'll extend it for 5-10 minutes. No. Guys, meantime, keep checking your notepad window. Over there, I'm sharing home.js component, and similar way you have to create. Okay, I think Shailendra is back. Shailendra, are you there? Guys, can you see my screen now? Okay, I'm sorry guys for the trouble. It happens sometimes, digitally things going on nowadays. So guys, this is what we have done. I'll stay here for 2 minutes. The home component, the about component, and the root contact component I have created. I have created these components under the component folder under the SRC. And now I'm going to route them into my main.js, which is my root component. Please give me a quick confirmation once you are good to go. If you want, I can show you all these three components together so that you can just make a benefit from that. So this is my home component. This is my about component. And this is my contact component. Once you are done with this, please let me know. I have created these components under the components folder. Yes, Anjesh, I can do it. Just give me 1 minute. You can check your notepad now, it is shared. Please write good to go or done once you are done with creating these three components, and we are good to configure my routes. Okay, so let's take up, guys. Now what I will be doing, I will be opening my main.js, which is my root component. If I go to my browser, my main component is rendering. Now what I will be doing is I will import the React router DOM. Under this React router DOM, I have a package called browser router, which is a inbuilt class for the routing. It's a little longer name that we have a hash router and browser router. Wanna tell by the browser router right now. It's a little long name. What I can do is, we have this privileges in JavaScript as well. I wanted to rename this package to the router name. So whenever I wanted to access my browser router, I can just use a router as a renamed package name. After that, we also need the route to integrate my router implementation or creating my route paths. Now I'll come to this render method. Under this render method, I'm gonna create a div would like to route that if someone will look out for, guys, you can see that I wanted to define the routes here. And what I said that if I wanted to define routes, I will be using a router as a renamed package. So I'm gonna start my router. And under that, I wanted to define multiple routes if someone will look out for the path home, then which component has to be rendered? The home component has to be rendered. Now, where is the home component? The home component is under the imports components folder. Under that, we have a home component. Under that, we have about component and contact component. So whatever components you wanted to configure into your routing, you first need to import them, and then you can render them as per your requirement. So first, let me make an import. Make sure you have created your component nicely. It's not showing me the contact here. I think, okay, that's perfectly fine. Now I said that if someone will look out for the home component, I wanted to render my home component. If someone will look out for the about path like this, the about component has to be rendered. Make sure whatever you are writing in a render method, that needs to be imported first, or you have created in the same component file, that's pretty fine. If someone will look out for contact path, you have to render the contact component. Guys, is my screen visible to all of you nicely? I'm displaying main.js. Guys, once you are done with this configuration, please let me know. And I also wanted to configure the route. If someone will not put any of the route, let's say localhost 3000 will be accessed, which is path is empty or default, at that point of time, I wanted to render the home component. And Jeshwara, all the files could not be shared. Already shared my index.js and home, about, and contact was a pretty simple component. I can do share it in, but sometime. Please try to write it by yourself and play around with the code. Because the code are sometimes not implemented, so that we need to keep writing. So guys, you can see that the moment I will go to my localhost 3000, the home page is getting rendered. As I discussed over my route, when none of the path gets selected, the home component has to be rendered. And when I'm gonna select any of the route from here, home, about, and contact, you can see that I'm going to the address bar for a couple of minutes. If I say home component, you can see that home component is rendering. If I say about component, I can say about component is rendering. And if I'm gonna move on to the contact component, it is saying that contact page is rendering. But the problem is, whatever I have in the default route, it is always coming same and it is rendering all the time. So this is really what I really don't need. So what I can do is, guys, while defining the path, I can just come up and use a property called exact. So exact is always needs to be implemented with the default path when we wanted to say that when exactly this default route matches. At that point of time, this component has to be rendered, not all the time. So I can just save it and I can just see that right now the contact is selected. So contact is rendering. If I will say about, the about is rendering, home is rendering. And when I am not selecting anything, that also home component is rendering. I really need your confirmation over this point. If you are pretty enough to take it up forward, make sure you import from the right folder or from wherever you have created it before using these components. We'll stay here for 1 minute and we'll take it up forward. I really need your confirmation over the chat window, people who are done with it. So Vishnu, basically hash router is used for hashing in the URL to render the component. Since, you know, when you build a static one page website, we need this. And browser router uses HTML5 history API to render the component. Whenever you render these component, the history can be modified via push state or replace state. So you can see these pages rendered over the history of your browser as well. Render is not a function. Render is really not a function. I think you are using here brackets. It is not bracket, it is curly braces. Please check the syntax, Vishvesh, and let me know. Guys, it really looks so ugly that every time I have to go to my address bar and I have to configure the Romil, how can you put all the routes in a separate file? You can create different components in a separate file, but routing has to be taken at one place, na? Vishnu, when we have a class component in place of contact, let's say contact is a function component, na? So we use a render method, okay? When we have this as a class component, we use a component property. Got it? Yes, Saxena, why it is doing it? Because we are making modifications onto the address bar. Okay, just stay for 5 minutes. I'm gonna tell you that part. Yannick, we have a lot of third-party implementations for single page. You can use them otherwise. Yes, Sunil, we can have. Okay, guys. So you can see that every time we're gonna move on to the address bar to make the modifications, which is really not a good practice. Vishnu, I am giving you the best practices. Component is a major property, can opt out for anyone. You can create a component class component, and you can use a render method. It will not be working. So component is a major part that works for the class and function, but generally we use it for class, okay? But render will only work for the functional component. So always try to use the best practices. Properties are also keeps your integration lightweighted. So use it nicely. So guys, it's really a bad practice to keep changing the address bar. What I'm gonna do is under the router, under this, I'm gonna create one more div, and here I would like to create the link. I first need to go to my line number 3, need to import the link API to create the navigation link. Creating a link, I said that if someone will click on home, I wanted to navigate to default route. How many of you are clear with it? So it will be displaying 3 links onto my page. So when I'm just writing about, it will be navigating to the about. Like this, when I will be writing the clicking on contact, it will be navigating to the contact page. But Sena, hold on for 2 minutes. I'm gonna tell you each and everything, okay? No problem. It is link. I will show you the nav link and the differences between them, okay? Just stay back. So guys, you can see that I have created 3 links, okay? When I'll just save it and I'll go back to my page, I can just put one thing. I can put a horizontal ruler between them. It will look a little better. So when I click on home, you can see that home page is rendering, about page is rendering, and contact page is rendering. So guys, can you please notice the reload button? Your page is not reloading. Why it was reloading earlier? Because you were manually hitting the address bar. Hitting the address bar manually means making a page post back property called up again and again. Okay, that's what your page gets reloaded every time. Now you can see that it's really, really very, very lightweighted single page application. You can see that your reload button will not be reloaded again and again. You click on the particular link, it will be going to check that route in the routing configuration, and as per that, it will make a call. Please give me a quick confirmation, guys, if it is pretty clear to everyone how exactly routing needs to be configured and the single page application has to be created using React client-side library. Give me a quick smile if it is working and you are clear with it.
Thank you.
Okay, guys, now let's take it up one step forward to tell you further iterations. Okay, so guys, people are asking that Bhavna, we do have two options. One is a link and one is a nav link. Okay, wanted to tell you that difference. Let's say right now you have created your navigations to your React routing with the help of link. Yes, Vishnu, each and every functionality is available in the router and the hash router, browser router and the hash router. Amir, it's a one-time import in the configuration, and I think you have to do it every time whenever you are talking about even the Angular or the React. Okay. Otherwise, you can create one import in Java, one JavaScript. You can write all your imports from there and you can add them into object and just export that object from there. A lot of ways are there. Okay. So guys, let me just comment out this div part. Rather than link, we do have one more property which is called nav link. Let me write this. And convert my link property to the nav link. And do the same, please. You can see that if I convert the link to the nav link, still everything works same. Home, about, and contact. I know that, Saxena. The difference between link and nav link is nav link helps you to style your component links. For example, you want that there is an active style property in the nav link. And say that color, I think two curly braces needs to be used. Color of the active style should be green. Let me keep it to each and every nav link that I have created. Active style means the route which is recently selected. For example, if I go here, the home is the default route that always be active. Apart from that, you can see that about is the active link and that is keep coming in a green color. When you click on the contact, your active style will be navigated to the contact. And you can see that now contact is appearing green in color. So guys, the major difference between link and nav link is it automatically inherits an active class when clicked. On the other hand, the link tag does not have an active class when clicked. So there are some differences. Yes, Saxena, it is inline style. Please give me a quick confirmation, everyone, if I am very, very clear to everyone with this implementation. And little buckle up your speech to take it up forward. Anjesh, you need to create one external CSS and you need to import into this import statement. Okay, and then you can use all the classes created there. Please give me a quick confirmation over the chat window by writing done. Because home is a default one, Rommel. Default one always integrates the active style. Please write done and continue to save time so that we are good to go. Okay guys, one last thing and then we will be moving to our next concept. I'm going to my component folder and this time I'm going to create one component. This time the component name would be the user component, okay? User.js. I can copy paste the stuff from the home component only and changing the name to my user component. Going to my main.js, going to import my user component. Going to configure the route for the user component as well. I'm going to render the user component. Yes, Saxena, this is the command. And I can see that I will also create one navigation link for that. And I can show you here. Home is working fine, about is working fine, contact is working fine, and user detail is also working fine. So what I really want now, over this user page, I wanted to pass the route parameter. Okay, right now I'm just passing any route parameter. If time allows, I'll tell you this thing again with the help of API router call. But this time I say that whenever I am going to call this user, I wanted to pass one static route parameter called John. That would be the username. And I wanted to assign to my user route as a route parameter. Guys, sometimes I hope you know that you pass a unique ID to your route. And according to that ID, the details of that product, the detail of that particular, product or employee or whatever ID you pass into your route parameter, according to that, your informations are retrieved. So I say that whatever name I will be passing into my user route that I wanted to access with the help of username. And now I wanted to access this username into my user component, right? So I'll go to my user.component. Here under this user functional component, I'll be using a match variable. And I'll say that once the user component renders, I wanted to read the parameter from the route. And I wanted to display the name hello match dot params dot, what is the name of the parameter? Username. You can see that it is giving error to me. I can just keep it h1 because I told you one parent element has to be there. I can keep it like h1, and this one I can keep it like h3. Props needs to be passed in a different way here. Just give me couple of more minutes. I'll help you out with that. No problem. Everything cannot be replaced anywhere. We just need to use it nicely. So whatever parameters you will be passing into this route at the time of calling that up, whatever name you have given to your route parameter, that you can access using the params array, params dot property name. And I can just go and see if I go to my user details. Okay. Here I can see that it's not reflecting. Let me just check that up. User is the route. John is the parameter which I am passing to the username, right? Colon is the appropriate implementation of passing the route. And here I need to come up and pass the match, and then it has to display. No problem. Sometimes it does not render. So I may need to restart it. Meantime, you can just ask me if you have any questions. If you are done with this, please let me know. So when you will go to your user details, it will display you the username along with the user page. Please give me a quick confirmation, guys, if passing the route to the route parameter is pretty clear to everyone. I'll stay here for 2 minutes to show you both the files together. And in case you have any questions, please come out. If you are done with this, don't hesitate to write done to save time. Yes, Fishface, the match parameter needs an expression. Saxena, I will not comment out on this part because I don't use Yarn. So I have never explored about it. But yes, you should use it as per your comfortability. Both are package managers. Okay. Please stay, Ravi. I will tell you that part. Will not take something new, which I really needs extra time for that. Will take up, okay? Guys, please give me a quick confirmation if we are good to go. We should have two components with different names rather than the same names. You can use it anytime as per your comfortability. So guys, now let's take up to the next part where I wanted to introduce how to consume the REST APIs into your React application. So guys, basically, different client side have different implementations, and React is a client side library. Okay, and if I talk about client side library, if you wanted to add any functionality or any conceptual implementation, you need help of third party packages. Okay. Similarly, if you wanted to, guys, I'm not going that detail what is RESTful API and all these things. These basics needs to be clear to everyone before coming in these sessions. So guys, when you wanted to communicate with the third party APIs, I really don't have any API, okay? So what I can do is I can just go and access my JSON placeholder, which is a free fake API ready for me, and I can just use it as per my requirement. Am I audible to everyone? No, it is not for creating Saxena. It is for consuming the RESTful API. So this website is slow today, but let's see how we can take it up. So what I'm gonna do is, guys, I'm gonna move on to my React application. First of all, let me just go. So someone was asking that link is defined but never used. It is coming from main.js. Earlier, we were using the link and then we have replaced our navigations by nav link. So you can just remove the link and you can see that your error has gone. So if I wanted to add any more third-party packages, I will go and I will add a new terminal and I will install my Exios library, which is a promise-based library, helps to consume the RESTful APIs. So you can see that I'm just gonna install this library to take it up, which will be helping me to consume the RESTful APIs, third party APIs even, okay? So once you are done with this installation also, please let me know over chat window. Today, this JSON placeholder typey code is not working for us. So, guys, just give me 1 minute. Let me try any other fake API. Because this website is down, it is having a list of fake API for users, for messages, for post, and then we can use that up. Let me try with any other URL if that works for me. So there is one more URL, get sorry, G-H-I-I, I think this one. So it returns us the list of films or movies. Okay, I think I have 20 movies here, which has the complete object, movie ID, title, and all these things. Let's try consuming this API. So are we good to go now? Okay, working at your end, guys, JSON placeholder. That is a nice one. If it is working at your end, you can use that. That's so implemented and easy for the front, for the beginners as well. Let me try into the another browser. JSON placeholder title code. Wait a second, guys. Let me try this. So I think some cache needs to be cleaned, but I will not play around with it right now in between of the session. I'll be consuming this. So guys, how can I share this with you? Can you just note down this URL quickly, guys? I'm going to display it here. Can you just give me a quick confirmation if you can access this? Is it visible to everyone? GHIBLI API. Ghibli.herokuapp.com/films. If anyone can access, please. Oh, I can put it in Notepad also. My bad. You can check it from the Notepad as well. And people who are noting down, please note it up. And let me know if you can access this and put that over the chat window, any one of you, so that we can take it up. Abhishek, please paste the URL over the chat window quickly. One who can access this. Okay, thank you so much, Saxena. It's really a great help. Now I'll go back to my application and make sure your Exeos package is installed successfully. You can also verify that once the package is installed, it is visible in your package.json dependencies. Okay. Now, guys, what I really wanted to do, it has a films. So what I can do, I can create a class component now. Okay, I'm not going to create the function component. By this way, the things will be more clear to you how to render the class component as well. Create a new component and say that as a movie list dot JavaScript. Create a class component, import from React. Component, React component, class movie list extends the component class, export default movie list, render, return the JSX, movie list. Wanted to go to my main.js. Going to import. Prakash, this question should not be validated. I told you yesterday, we do manage the states in the class component. We do have a lifecycle hook method in the class component that we do not have in function component. Isn't it? You were not there in the last session. So I have imported it and I just wanted to configure here, first of all, route path equals to movies. Have a look. Right now I'm using here a component property rather than the render property. And I will switch to the render property and I'll show you. That's a movie list. And then I'm going to create a link for that. Movies. I'm going to my application where it is. Keeping a segregator between them. I click on the movies, my movies list is rendering. Now I can show you guys, if you wanted to convert your component property to the render property, it should not work. You can see that class constructor movie list cannot be invoked with new. So basically when you actually use a component property, it instantiates your component first, movie list first, and then calls its render method. Please give me a quick confirmation if I'm clear. It is a class component. First, you need to create an object of the class and then you can access the members of it. Yes or no? It's a general programming approach, object-oriented approach. Class needs to be instantiated and then it needs to be accessed by all these members, whatever you are writing here. So when you use a component property, it actually instantiates your class. And when you use a render method, it never instantiates, it's directly execute. So that is actually the implementation between them. You can replace the render with component anytime, but you don't have any option to replace the component with render for the class component. Please give me a quick confirmation if it is pretty clear and your movie list is getting rendered. Now I wanted to consume my movies REST API from my application into my application. I'm waiting for your confirmation with a good smile. Guys, I can see little less interactions. Are you not enjoying the session? Are you not enjoying the session, guys? Please answer the question which I have asked right now. Wait, Sunil. First of all, let me ask my question. If you are not enjoying, then we should take it up accordingly. Okay. Thank you so much. So let's go to the movie list and let's try to consume the REST API. I think everyone is good to go now. Just 1 minute. So now, first of all, we need to import our Exios library. And over this Exios library, I need to actually come up and consume the movies list. Okay. So first of all, go to the import and import the Exios package. After that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to the class level. guys, now I'm gonna introduce the best way to create the state variables. Yesterday I just told you very quickly how the state has to be managed. The better way to manage your states is using a constructor. I hope you know that whenever you create the object of your component, the constructor invokes and allocates the memory to the data members and the variables declared inside the constructor. And when you see that your component class is no longer in use, it will release its memory. So it will also release the memory occupied by the state. Please give me a quick confirmation if it is clear to everyone. Vishnu, I cannot use functional component now. Please understand. I cannot manage states and I do not have lifecycle hook methods there. I told you yesterday only that it needs to be used for the static pages. I wanted to make a full-fledged functionality. I wanted to make my application integrated and lightweight also, right? So guys, create a constructor. Look out for the additional external props. If you use a constructor, you are extending your component class. Never forget to call your super class constructor and passing the props if in case required. If no props needs to be passed, then the default props needs to be integrated. I wanted to use a this.state. I wanted to create a list of movies. Okay, so can you also use lifecycle hook methods, Vishnu, over there? Please enjoy the session. Okay. So guys, this is a state that I have created, and under that I wanted to keep a list of movies here. Guys, render is a method which helps you to return the JSX to the client, whatever you write inside it. Just like I was talking about the lifecycle hook method, guys, having not enough time to explain each and every hook method, you can just self-explore them. But I wanted to introduce one of the lifecycle hook method that executes after the constructor. If you will be invoking your APIs into the constructor, your initial load of your application will become heavy, and it will take time to load your application. That's what, after loading my components, I keep calling asynchronously my RESTful APIs or third-party APIs. A method that invokes after the constructor in the initialization phase is component did mount. Once the component is successfully initialized and mounted, this did mount initialization phase is invoked, and this is the right place to call your RESTful APIs. Please give me a quick confirmation. Axios is a promise-based library, and you know that to consume the RESTful API, we have four uniform methods: get, put, post, and delete. Am I right, guys? Get is to get the resources. Post is to add the new object or resource to your API while adding a new data. Put is to update the resource, and delete is to delete the resource. As of now, I wanted to get the list of movies. It is a get request. So get, we have a get, we have a put, we have a post. So I wanted to make a get API call. Guys, do you have any idea about promise-based libraries, asynchronous approach in JavaScript? I'm just asking. If no, that's okay. No problem. Guys, I will suggest you to go and learn asynchronous approach. It is very good for the UI developers. Axios is a promise-based library. When you will be calling this API will either resolve the data, resolve the promise, or it will reject the promise. If the promise is resolved, it means the API gets called up successfully. Then method has to be executed. If it is rejected, then catch method has to be executed. Please give me a quick confirmation if it is clear to everyone. Kiran, make sure you have this Axios imported. Okay, first thing is make sure you have your npm install Axios command executed over your terminal to get this package, get this promise based library. Okay, after that you need to import it into your import statements and then you can access it. And make sure you are using the right spelling. Give me a quick confirmation if line number 15, 16 and 17 is clear to everyone. Axios is a promise-based library. Promise can either be resolved or rejected. If the promise is resolved, then method has to be executed to take a further implementation. If it is not resolved, it is rejected. Maybe you have a privilege issue, so you cannot access, or it is down, or the URL is not correct. Then catch method has to be executed to give you the errors. Can I get more confirmations, guys? Thank you so much for these emojis. So I said, if there is any error, I would like to say error and console.log. Error and print whatever you have in the error object. If everything goes fine, it's perfectly fine actually. So in that case, what you can see that you will get your result object in your then method and you wanted to say console.log whatever you have into your result. So I can just go to my application. When I'm rendering my movie list, I can just inspect. I can go to the console. Okay, no problem. Superclass constructor is invoked using props. What it is saying else? We are doing that only. Constructor props and this dot status created after creating after calling the props. Okay. Line number 8. Okay, guys, no problem. You can take your time. I have refreshed. I refreshed, by the way. Very amazing. So guys, you can see that the data is coming. I refreshed, by the way, but no problem. You can refresh or restart your application in case you don't want it. You can't access them. So you can see that your API gets called up successfully. The status code is 200, okay, and your array is there. And this is the API that you wanted to read out. And just give me a quick confirmation if you get this result object. And we are successfully good to populate that into my application at this client page. Can I get a quick confirmation, guys, if everyone is good to go with? In case, yeah, I thought I need to restart, so I missed that part. So guys, in case you do not write the right API, just keep incorrect API here. And just you can see that. It is saying that, just refresh it once again. It is saying that 404, because the API that you are trying to access is not there. And I can just zoom it out. And you can see that whatever you write as a message into your catch, you will be getting that along with whatever error message is coming, that is request failure with status code. Please give me a quick confirmation, guys, if everything works pretty good to everyone, how to consume the RESTful API using Axios library. So Gavin has the question. Yes, Fetch is also one of the implementation to consume the REST API, but Axios is a quite performed library and asynchronously handle all the requests and easy to handle by the developers also. Please write over the chat window, fetching movies list successfully. I'll stay here for 2 minutes. If you have any questions, please come out. If you are done, don't hesitate to write it down so that I can take it up quickly. Waiting for more confirmation, staying here for 1 more minute. Okay, so I am just replying to, Vishnu, right? So Vishnu, if you wanted to consume the REST API in functional component, first of all, you need to use a use state, as you were rightly saying that state hook method is there, but you have to use it with React package, react.useState, okay? And then after that, you need to use a side effect hook, which is a use effect to call the API with props dot whatever message, whatever property you wanted to access that up. So use effect is basic. Use state is basically a hook, provides a state variable to the functional component because people like you wanted to integrate by both of the way. But suggestion is to use a class component. And then we have the objects like translation, set translation, for packing and unpacking the capabilities to extract the variable which is retrieved by the API. And then whatever callbacks, for example, right now we are using a then and catch, which is pretty enough implemented and easy to use. Otherwise, if you are using the functional component, you need to use array of dependencies or callback functions. And component did mount. What I wanted to tell you that component did mount is the basically the hook lifecycle function in the class component, and we don't have class hook methods in functional. So use effect, which I'm talking about, is basically the replacement of something with component did mount. Okay. I hope I'm clear to you guys, especially Vishnu. See, when we talk about all these questions, Vishnu, I wanted to answer out one thing to you. When we talk about the real-time application nowadays, might you heard about, we use a design patterns. Some of the design patterns are easy to integrate, but they are little highly performed. But we use it, why? Because if any third person joins your team, or if any changes are required, and everyone knows that design pattern is being implemented, so the making changes to the existing code becomes easier in the later stage. So whenever we develop the application, we don't think about the very, very current situation. We also think about that in later scenarios when we will be actually maintaining our code. At that point of time, how will you be integrating all these things? So that is what we use. We should use a best practices. We should trade off, and trade off never always has to happen to reduce the time complexity. Sometimes to reduce the time complexity that the functional component is there, obviously. Sometimes to reduce the space complexity, space is samely required in both the ways. And sometimes to reduce the time and efforts of programmer also along with time complexity. That's what your class component is achieving here. And making your code maintainable for the further implementation and the maintenance purpose. Guys, I hope I'm able to answer out this query very nicely. When you should opt out the best approach exactly to come up to solve your issues. Okay, guys. Yes, Vishnu, that's true. Some life cycle hook methods are not expired. We cannot say this word. We can say that it is depreciated. So some of useful methods are there that you can use them. Okay, guys, without wasting time here or there, let's take up. I'm going to do one thing. I'm going to create a const movies equals to whatever I have in my result. So guys, you can see that when I'm able to see my array, it is giving a lot of information to me related to my API call. It is giving me the config object, data object, header object, request object. I just wanted to access the data which is having the array list. Okay. So what I wanted to do now. I wanted to assign the data to the movies. Anjesh, please understand it's a webinar and we have a proper implementation that can be implemented. A different series would be required. Okay, we will keep you posted with our videos if you are interested and over the next time. We only have 20 minutes. I wanted to tell you by the state implementation right here. Okay, we do have, but that's a different series. So guys, we have a data assigned to the const. I wanted to already have my movies into my state variable. I wanted to say that this dot set state movies, whatever you have here in this variable, you can just keep it like movies list so you will not get confused. If you wanted to now console.logout what you have in your this.stage.movies, okay, this needs to be returned outside the setState method. You can make it more summarized by writing this way. Give me a quick confirmation if these statements are clear. Now, when I'm just coming up, this list is coming from the state. This list is not coming up from the result variable, result object. Okay. So Vishnu, basically here the state is managed at the component level. When you wanted to manage your state at the application level, you use Redux. Okay. Thank you so much, Shreya. I was doing that mistake. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to move on to my render method quickly, and I wanted to say that here I just come up. I wanted to create the table ehead table row eh into 3. What happened? I'm not able to create it today. Okay, let me do that. Here I wanted to display only few informations, three columns. One is title, producer and release date. Okay, title of the movie, producer name and the release date. And after that, I wanted to integrate the body. Under that, I wanted to integrate the TD three times. One for the title, one for the producer. Guys, can you please help me out? What should I use here? I told you the map method, na? Yesterday? Vishnu, we will keep you guys posted very soon when we will be having a next webinar, okay? This dot, okay, keep it in the curly brace. This dot, page dot, here we have a movies dot map, movie and the index, or I, you can keep it anything. And under that, I will be keeping my TR. Even though we should keep this TR under the return JSX. Guys, you can also do one thing. You can create an additional component as I did yesterday, and you can render this over there. Okay. I'm not keeping it. You can easily manage it. You can summarize my 2 days session and then you can play around with it. Under this TD, I wanted to say that whatever object I have in this parameter, the object name dot title. And I should be able to access that. Let me just write and check that. Movie dot producer. Movie dot. What was the next property I wanted to access? Release date. Can you see this, guys? Thank you so much, Vishnu. You can see that, guys. Here I'm getting my list of movies. I can just little improve my table by keeping the border. You can use Bootstrap to make your application attractive. I'm just keeping it like the simple way that I could manage in my time span. And have a look, guys. The list of movies are there. Give me a quick smile over the chat window. If creating this single page application, your page is not at all reloading, passing the route parameter also, and accessing the asynchronous data. You can see that, guys, when I click on movies, it takes a little time because it reloads the data asynchronously, but it will not keep your constructor halted. Okay. I really need this quick smile over the chat window if you people are super, super clear about it. And I will stay here for 2 minutes. If you have any questions, please come out. If you are done, please let me know. Don't forget to tell me how many of you have executed and getting the result. Thank you so much, everyone. It really means a lot. Vishnu, you have to use third-party APIs for them. We have do have a loaders. First of all, you should have a loader image, and then you can easily use that. I hope you get a pretty enough idea to integrate, and you can add whatever things you wanted to implement them. So guys, shall I take it up forward and take a one step more implemented if you people are pretty clear about it? If I go to my movies list here, by this Heroku. I have these movies list. If I just copy this ID and keep it into my route parameter like this, you can see that I'm getting a one particular movie object here. I hope I'm clear what I am saying. Now I wanted to take that up, so I will go. And I will create one more component, which is a show component or movie detail component, whatever name you wanted to give. Movie detail dot JavaScript. After that, I'll just create the Here I'm gonna import statement. Please do it with me. We are almost touching the last part, so we could able to complete it before time. And here I'm saying that the class movie detail that extends the component render return the JSX fetching the movie detail, and just gonna export my component from here. Now what I have to do, guys, first of all, we have to go to my app.js and I need to configure my route with API, with route parameter. So I'll go to my main.js. I'll create one route. Whenever someone will look out for path, movie detail, and will pass the ID, is that ID variable? Yes. You can give any name to here, by the way, but generally I try to keep it with the same name, right, Satish? Okay. And I wanted to render the component. Guys, I wanted to tell you one thing here. When you will be writing movie detail, you can see that movie detail is not imported. So very pretty implementation is there. There is an auto import feature in Visual Studio Code especially. Then you will be looking out for movie detail. It will auto import your movie detail into your imports. Can you see this, guys? You don't have to type it completely. The moment you will be writing, it will be showing in an enumeration list, and you can select from that enumeration list. You can see that, guys. Movie list. I hope I'm pretty clear about it. Now, how can I access this route? I need to go to my movie list I'm going to create one actions column. And here I'm going to create the list of movies that I have, and over there I wanted to call my API. So I will be using a link or router link, whichever you wanted to use. Nav link you can also use. Here I'm using link import from React router DOM. Import the link attribute. Okay. And after that, just guys, we will talk about that in a couple of minutes. If you wanted to learn more about React, just stay for 5 more minutes. Let me complete this activity. Okay, I'm gonna create a TD here. I will say that the link has to be created. If you will look out for the route that you have created in your main.js, that is movie detail ID. Okay. Access this from here. Keep it in the curly braces, first of all, because it's an expression, guys. Don't forget to use this expression binding. Don't use this ID implementation. You are already inside a map method. There we have a movie.id accessible. Please give me a quick confirmation if I'm rightly saying it. We are inside the map, right? So under the iterative variable, if I am, and I wanted to access. So guys, I think it is L capital, right? And you can see that I will be writing here a view detail link. And when I'm going to click on this view detail link, it is saying that index.js does not match the corresponding name. Okay, no problem. Let me first hit my localhost 3000 once again, and it gets halted. No problem. Let us go to our node shell. And it is saying that movie detail is not exported. It is exported from here. It is added here in the component. And this movie detail is accessible in the movie list. And now let's hit a restart. Meantime, if you have any questions, please come out. If I made any little implementational mistake in front of you and you are able to track that, please let me know. So guys, I think the mistake I have implemented is a React. Okay, it is lowercase React. You can see that a small hit can keep you in trouble. So you have to play around nicely. So you can see that we have a view detail. And when I click on the view detail, can you see this, guys? It's a beauty of route parameter. I really love this concept. Whatever view detail you're going to click, the corresponding ID for that particular movie gets sent to your route parameter. Okay, and afterwards, what you can do, guys, you can actually come to your movie list or a movie detail. You can consume the API that I am displaying you here by ID, and you can use state variable to iterate your object. I hope you can do that part. Am I right? How many of you are getting this view detail successfully called up and you are able to get this route parameter at the movie detail route? Please let me know. Now you have to import your movie detail here with the help of a state management, or if Vishnu wants it by functional component, you can do it by any of the ways. And you can play around and you can complete the entire CRUD operation as well. So guys, there are so many things. There are the authentication, login, logout state. There are controlled and uncontrolled forms in React. There is testing in React. React is also a very big library that you guys should able to understand. Please give me a quick confirmation if you are done till this movie detail and we are good to go up. Vishnu, one thing I want to tell you, dear, when we have a secure routes, then this is a very, very right way to do that, or a secure way as well. You need to secure all these routes, whatever you can access them. No one can change it. See, if admin can log in by the login functionality, if you have authorized your application, authenticate your application, no one can access it, dear. You have to secure your routes. So guys, we will do one thing. We will upload this code over GitHub and this link will be available to you over a description box in some time, not immediately, after some time you will get that up, okay? We don't have exactly the same way, Sunil Babu, but we actually have, because it is a client-side library, and I hope you know that .NET is a server-side programming, right? It's a framework. So that difference will always be there, but yes, we have all the alternatives of them that we could achieve it by the third-party packages, okay? You have to dig into that. Vishnu, first of all, answer me one thing. Why admin will do this? If your admin will play around with your data, then why you will make that person admin? Yes, Sunil, you are absolutely right. We have an action guard in Angular. We do have the secure guards in making our route secure in React as well. We do have those alternatives. So that's what Vishnu, I'm telling you, you can make your URL secure, or you can just hide your ID from your route, as I think one participant was earlier asking. I'm not sure the name of that participant. We have that way.
Thank you.
So guys, this is a very clear answer to everyone, Vishnu, Ravi, and one more participant who was asking. We do have that way to only show the domain in the browser and do not update your URL while you make a click on that. If we will get time, we will upload that video over our YouTube channels. Otherwise, you can just wait for the next webinar, or you can join our training program where we will be teaching you all these things. Choice is totally yours, okay? Because we do had only 2 days program, and I hope we are touching the cross limit. So guys, as I was telling you, although I am a new blogger, since having 12 years of experience in this industry, I never get time to upload much of the code over Git and YouTube, but I am planning to do ahead. And one thing I want to tell you can follow me .net, follow me over the Bhavna Gunbani YouTube channel or my social media activities, and you can follow the .net tweaks, and you can just follow us in case we will be uploading any series. I'm planning to do that super soon. So you can follow me over here with the name of Bhavna Gunwani, or you can just follow .NET Tweaks from where you have logged in right now, and we will be able to help you out that way. And there are the other social media handles. You can follow me over the Facebook page, LinkedIn, or Twitter. You will get an update from here or there. Okay. Vishnu, we cannot interact with database in React. React is a client-side library. If you want to do that, you need to use Node.js for that, okay? Sure, Vishwas. Vishnu, just go to my website here, as I discussed right now, and you can get all the social media handles over here. And you can just see that all the social media handles are there, okay? It's with the name of Bhavna Gunwani. You can follow me anywhere. Okay, guys, thank you so much. And Shailendra, are you there?
Yeah, hi, Bhavna. Thank you for this wonderful session. I really appreciate your timing in the weekend. I hope the people like the session a lot.
My pleasure. Over to you. Thank you so much, everyone.
Yeah. So, guys, if you are joining us first time, I request you to please do subscribe to .NETX YouTube channel so that the information about such webinars you will get out. You will get the notification. In upcoming week, we having a training on AWS and Microsoft Azure. So please keep visiting the .NETX.com and do subscribe to .NETX YouTube channel. Thank you again for joining the day two of React.js training program. Again, thank you, Bhavna, for taking this session.
My pleasure, guys. All the